I have found the light of the enhanced input action system, and soon you will too. Never will you want to use the old system ever again. This is a brand new system to Unreal Engine 5.1 and was made from the ground up to make all input related code not only easier to read and modify, but it can also improve performance and reduce bugs. Right now, this code works by taking the E key, then setting a bool before doing an action based off if it has started, is happening, or ended. Right now, the code is rather cumbersome as it needs to make use of many branch nodes and the event tick node to work. But with the enhanced input, we can use one input node to do all of this. To start with enhanced input, go to the content browser and make a new folder called inputs. Then in that folder, right click and under input, make a new input action, then give it a name and open it. Inside the input action, you will see something that looks like the old system from the project settings. You can look at the options here to see what you can do. Under value type, you can choose if it is an analog system, like for a controller, or a digital system, like for a keyboard. Then under triggers, you can choose stuff like a delay or a combo or a pulse, unlike in the past when all that was done in code only. There are even more options under modifiers, but for what we want to do, we will be fine leaving the defaults. You can then save and close the window. Now back in the content browser, you want to make an input mapping context and name and open it. Then in content, you will see something that looks like the mapping of old. Press the plus next to mappings. Then in the dropdown, you can select the input action from before. Now you can select a key just like you used to. You can also do those same triggers and modifiers in here and choose if you want the input to be player mappable. If you want to make a key binding screen, you can use that to allow for the player to change the mapping. Now you can save and close the mapping. Now back in the player blueprint, we can see the event begin play. Here the code is setting up the mapping context for the player input subsystem. To use our code, we will need to add our own mapping context to the input subsystem. To do that, we will need an add mapping context node connected to the player subsystem and set to the new context. Now we can search for the input action and select it. You will then see the enhanced input action node. This node is much more powerful than the old input system. To test this, we will take that old code from the intro and fix it using the new system. To do this, I will simply copy the three print strings that I had before, and I will hook up start to the started event, stop to the completed event, and happening to the triggered event. Now, instead of needing booleans and branch nodes and the tick node, all I need is my actual code and the engine does everything else. This makes your code much more readable and better to maintain as your project grows. The triggered event happens while your button is held down, the started event happens once at the start, and the completed pin happens when you let go, all in one package. You can then compile your new code and you'll see that it works just like the old code, but better. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. If you like the video, a subscription would make my day, and if you ring that bell, you can get notified anytime I make a new tutorial. If you want to test out your new enhanced input action skills, why not watch this video and try to make the controls use the new system? Any questions or concerns, please leave them in the comment section or in my Discord, and I will love to get back to you. Until next time, have a great day, and bye for now!